When we view the solar eclipse during the lead up to the eclipse, or when the moon is just starting to pass in front of the sun and we have partial phases of the eclipse, and then same thing after totality as the moon is starting to move back off of the disk of the sun, it's really important to wear the safety glasses so you're protecting your eyes. The most common way to safely view the sun is using solar viewers or eclipse glasses, and those are designed to block enough of the light from the sun so that it's safe to still look straight at the sun. It's dangerous to stare directly at the sun because our eyes have lenses that are kind of like a magnifying glass. And so if you've ever tried to start a fire with a magnifying glass where it's bringing the sun's light to a sharp focus, the same kind of thing happens with our eyes. So if we stare directly at the sun, that same focusing effect happens onto the back of our eyeball, and that can burn and damage our eyes. Just as we want a high SPF to protect our skin, the higher the rating or how much light the solar filters are blocking is necessary to also protect our eyes. And so we want those much, much darker eclipse glasses than just the sunglasses. In terms of getting your own eclipse glasses, you can go to a website like eclipse.ohio.gov, and they'll have a list of reputable dealers and places where you can go to make sure that your eclipse glasses are safe for use. You want to look for ISO 12312-2, and that's the international standard for the correct kind of darkness filter that we need to safely view the sun. It's important to use your solar viewer, your eclipse glasses, or a card that's got a similar filter on it, and use that to hold up over your camera's lens for a cell phone, or using a specialty filter for a bigger lensed camera than a cell phone. A pinhole viewer is a little device that you can construct, which allows you to safely view the sun without needing eclipse glasses. So you can make a pinhole viewer out of something like a cardboard box. Put a sheet of white paper on the opposite side of the box from where your pinhole is. Cut a hole in one end of the box and fill that hole with some aluminum foil. So you can make a really precise pinhole. And then, without looking at the sun, kind of point the pinhole back towards the sun, and you can move it around a little bit until you see the image on your white piece of paper as you're looking kind of up through the box. You've got a good surface for projecting that image of the sun onto. So once you've got that, you've got yourself a pinhole viewer. Instead of making a maybe a little bit complicated pinhole viewer yourself, you can use something like even just a colander from the kitchen. It does a similar kind of effect. Each hole in the colander is acting like a little pinhole. Just like the pinhole viewer or the colander, you can kind of make your own little version with just your hands by nestling your hands together, so you're creating a few little holes for the sunlight to pass through. So you're wearing eclipse glasses or eclipse viewers. But during that brief few minutes of totality, you actually want to take your eclipse glasses off so that you can view the splendor of the eclipse. Pay attention to that, what's happening, which part of the eclipse it is. But as long as you're doing that and you're protecting your eyes during the partial phases of the eclipse, it's safe to view the eclipse.